Listen. Here's the thing. If you can't spot the sucker in your first half hour at the table, then you are the sucker. Guys around here will tell you, you play for a living. It's like any other job. You don't gamble, you grind it out. Your goal is to win one big bet an hour. That's it. Get your money in when you have the best of it, and protect it when you don't. Don't give anything away. That's how I've paid half my way through law school. A true grinder. See, I learned how to win a little at a time. But finally, I've learned this. If you're too careful, your whole life can become a fucking grind. This is Teddy KGB's place. You won't find it in the yellow pages. He doesn't look like much, but KGB is connected all the way to the top of the Russian mob. He's the one guy in the game you don't want to fuck with. But if you're looking for high stakes, this is the only place in town. They all know me as a small timer. But that's about to change. The game in question is No Limit Texas Hold'em. Minimum buy-in $25,000. A game like this doesn't come together often outside the casinos. The stakes attract the rich flounders, and they in turn attract the sharks. No Limit Texas Hold'em is the Cadillac of poker. Each player is dealt two cards face down. Five cards are then dealt face up across the middle. These are the community cards everyone can use to make the best five-card hand. The key to the game is playing the man, not the cards. There's no other game in which fortunes can change so much from hand to hand. A brilliant player can get a strong hand cracked, go on tilt, and lose his mind along with every single chip in front of him. But there are others, like Doyle Brunson, who consider No Limit the only pure game left. Like Papa Walinda said, life is on the wire. The rest is just waiting.
What about? About 500.
It's a position race. I call it.
Here's the beauty of this game.
Go ahead.
I just got top two pair on the flop, and I want to keep him in the hand. So what I've got to do is overbet the pot. Make him look like I'm trying to buy it.
I bet 2,000.
Then he plays back at me, and I get paid off.
I call him.
My guess is Teddy's on a flush draw.
Born and torn.
There's my money card. Nine of hearts. I got a full house.
To the better.
Check's good.
Now I hope a spade falls, and Teddy makes his flush. That way he'll bet strong, and I'll beat him with my nines full of aces.
I'm going to bet. I bet 15,000.
I want him to think I'm pondering a call, but all I'm really thinking about is Vegas and the fucking Mirage.
Alright, so here's your 15. Plus I have another 33. Yeah, I'm gonna go all in because I don't think you got the spades.
You are right. I don't have spades.
I know before the cards are even turned over.
I says fool, Mike.
You don't hear much about guys who take their shot and miss, but I'll tell you what happens to them. They end up humping crappy jobs on graveyard shifts, trying to figure out how they came up short. See, I had this picture in my head, me sitting at the big table, Doyle to my left, Amarillo Slim to my right. Playing in the World Series of Poker. And I let that vision blind me at the table against KGB. Now the closest I get to Vegas is West New York. To rounders who forget the cardinal fucking rule. Always leave yourself outs.